guys. Hopefully you can see me. If not, I'll try to scoot down a little bit. It is finally here, guys. It is time to plant those seeds, okay? We are doing a seed starting video, and I hope y'all ready. Get your tools, get your stuff, get all the things that you're ready to plant, and stay tuned. I'll be right back to you.
Nobody stopping my shine. They try to break me, try to take me out, but I got Jesus on my side. Feel so bad I thought I would die, but ain't no power stronger than the one that came and laid down his life. And I got mountains to climb, but the enemy can't stop me, 'cause there's a calling on my life. So when I'm crying, don't last too long, 'cause he gon' step in and make it alright. Won't he do it? Your battles for you, they gon' wonder how you sleep at night. Only do it, yes he will.
Welcome back. This is a new view for us. So you might not see my face often in this video, but I'm gonna try to adjust this camera just a little bit so you can see. I am in my living room because it is too cold in my garage and it is too cold outside right now. But we have to get these seeds started. It is the first week in March. I like to get my seeds started either last week's in February or the first week in March. So maybe around April, into April, we're ready to put them in the ground outside. And that's past the first frost. No, the last frost. In 7A. That's going to be past the last frost for the year. And that's when I like to put my stuff in the ground so it won't freeze over. So, again, I am in Upper Marlboro, Maryland. That is considered 7A as far as your zone. And if you are in 7A, guys, it's time to start seeding if you haven't already done so. I'm a little late. I had a lot of moving and stuff to do. All right, so let me just give y'all a few of the things that I like to start seeds with. I'm not particular about what you start the seeds with. The reason why I decided to use these this year is because they're biodegradable, which means that instead of dumping the plant out and then, you know, tossing the roots and stuff like that, getting them all, you know, discombobulated, I don't have to do so. I can actually just plant these little cups right into the ground where I would like my each of my seedlings to go. So that's one thing that I suggest. But you can use anything. You can use the plastic ones because I did use the plastic ones last year. So use whatever you like. Secondly, something to put it in. Since I'm in the house, I don't need a big old shovel or anything right now. So I just use a really, really, really large spoon to put my dirt in. Or fork so that I can, you know, grade my dirt up and thing. I don't use big tools while I'm in the house. Only for when I go outside. Labeling is very important. You don't want to forget what you planted. Last year I did have some experiences with that, so I basically had to wait for the fruit to be produced in order to determine what I planted. So yes, that does happen. It sounds like crazy, but it happened. And then you have your packs of seeds and things, okay? This year I am doing some repeaters. Ozark Giants. Those are my green, red, sweet bell peppers. So they're green starting off if you want to pick them early. They're red as in maturity. Ozark Giants were like a blessing last year. They did sprout out late because last year we had a crazy sun. So it was burning up everything. So those came out the ground really good. I would say in August, like through August through September, like I had, oh my God, so many green peppers. I was able to give them to my neighbors and things like that. I am doing a sweet pepper carnival blend. It's a lot of different colors here. Yellow, purple, orange, white, red. I haven't tried this before, so that's not a repeat. I'm doing one tomato. I'm doing a couple of different variety of tomatoes, but this one that I'm actually planting is called Just Delicious. It's by Burpee. Haven't tried that one yet. This is a repeater from Harley Seeds. I did get Red Robin tomatoes last year. Those are the miniature cherry red tomatoes. That's a repeat. It wasn't so well last year because I did plant it really late in the season. But let's just hope for the best this year. And tomatoes were like terrible last year also because, again, the weather and the sun, it was just burning everything up last year. What I did have big success with is the cucumber by Ferry Morse. Pick a bushel. This was, my iguana is going crazy over here, y'all. Pick a bushel cucumbers. I can't express this enough. These things were wonderful for pickling. They were wonderful for putting in your salad as just a regular cucumber. It's called Ferry Morse Cucumber Pick a Bushel. I cannot express enough how good these were. And last but not least, I am doing, well, you know what? I don't really know if I'm doing this. I might just drop these in the ground. I've noticed that green beans have a better production just being dropped right in the ground instead of being replanted. These are Ferry Morse Bean Garden Blue Lake 274. I had good success with this, but I had better success just dropping them in the ground. So I'm going to put these in the bucket for right now with my other things that I'm dropping in the ground. I'm doing watermelon, bush sugar babies. I'm doing marigolds. I'm dropping them right in the ground outside. So when I go outside after the first, after the last frost, I'm going to say give or take 2 to 3 weeks, I'm dropping all my marigold seeds around my perimeter so I can keep the deers away from there. Because this year I have to do an all container garden in the back because I have a smaller patio. I'm planting stuff in the ground at my mom's. So those are going to be the melons. I have pumpkins. Two variety of pumpkins. I have watermelon, cantaloupe. The melons are going to my mom's house. And the green beans I'm going to put back here, but I'm going to put them in a raised garden bed because I don't like to transplant the green beans. I had better luck just putting them in the ground. They grew up just the way they were supposed to, and they're bush variety. So they're not going to be going all over the place. They're going to be pretty in a stable area. They're not going to travel so much. And the same with the cucumbers. I do have a bush variety of the cucumbers because if you don't get them, I can tell y'all, cucumber will take over your whole garden, guys. You don't want that unless you do. But cucumbers, they grow these like spiny, kind of twisty, wiry vines, and they will choke your other plants. I can't make this up. They choke because they're climbers. So they wrap around anything they could get to, and they'll choke it down. So they'll take down your whole garden if you are not careful. So let's get started here, guys. I'll do one example. As far as fertilizers, I don't have to use fertilizers this early. One reason is because I use Miracle-Gro. This is what I prefer. Miracle-Gro Seed Starting Pot Mix. It has all the nutrients that it's going to need for the next 6 to 7 weeks. So I don't over-fertilize when I'm first starting off. Everything that's in this potting mix, seed starter, it's everything that this plant needs for the first 6 to 7 weeks. Now, when I transplant into my pot, my bigger pots in the ground, I will be using the different kind of fertilizer. I have bone meal. I have chicken poop. Yes, I said it. Lime. Epsom salt. I have all of those different things, but I won't be using those until I actually transplant everything, okay? So I'm going to start off with this bag. I have some peat moss, too. Peat moss just keeps it very moisturized while it's in there. You don't have to keep watering these plants because peat moss holds a lot of water, but it also protects your plants so that you're not overwatering it and drowning the seed and thing. All right, so I'm gonna start. I'm gonna be real simple, y'all. I'm gonna try to do as less mess, especially since I'm in a house. I did put some plastic bags down and stuff, but I'm gonna try to be not so messy. But let's see how we go. Either way, I'm gonna have to clean up anyway, so really doesn't matter, huh? But as you can see, all I'm doing is filling the pots, filling the pots, filling the pots, filling the pot. I could be doing this with my hand. I'm trying to be a little okay. Just throw all the neatness out the window because I got dirt all in my slippers and everything. I'm about to do this with my hand, y'all. I am a hands-on type of person. I don't believe in wearing them gloves unless you're dealing with all the different types of soils that could cause fungal diseases and stuff in your hand. That's when you need to, you know, think about stuff. But right now, this is just a seed starter, very basic, simple. All right, I have my dirt in here. What I do, tap, tap, tap. I tap it because I want all the dirt to get down. I want it to be not necessarily packed as much because with a seed starter, it's a very, very thin and loose type of dirt. And it's mainly so that your seeds won't get stuck with growing out and sprouting out. So once I pack it down, I like to water it then. I do not water after. I don't want my seed getting lost somewhere and not being in the middle where I actually put the seed in the first place. So I am about to get the water, guys, and water this down. I'm actually just about to walk to the sink because I don't feel like bringing water into the living room. So I'm about to walk to the sink and get it watered down. I'll be right back. Okay, guys, I'm back. I tossed some water in my trays. It's now packed down really tight. So I am now going to just either you could do it with your hands or you could do it with some type of tool. I am going to put about a half an inch indention in these pots. I may plant one or two seeds per hole only because they're not going to both last. I'm going to tell you that. And if they do both last, you're going to have to do some surgery because it's best to plant a lot of seeds and have enough plants in the, instead of planting a minimum amount of seeds and not having many that survive, okay? This is a doggy dog world out here, y'all. They ain't going to all survive, okay? They're going to be fighting. All right, so I'm going to start with my cucumber seeds. All right, again, I got about half an inch, almost an inch. With these bigger seeds, I can go a whole inch. And all I'm going to do is plant two seeds per hole. They do not have to be next to each other. I did make the hole big enough to get two seeds across. It's a doggy dog world. Remember what I said, whichever one lasts, the one that's the strongest is the one that's going to be kept. I'm going to be doing some surgery on these babies, so if they don't all both make it, oh well, sorry for you. But I'm planting them two seeds per hole. No, they're not next to each other. I did spread them out a little bit because I made a really long hole, like two seeds. Get them in there. Don't worry about tucking them or anything like that unless you're just spreading them out, because I am going to be putting up, I dropped three in there, so they're gonna really be fighting. And again, these are last year seeds, so they're still fresh. They haven't expired. Yes, seeds have an expiration date if you did not know. So I'm gonna put these seeds up because I might need them later on when I want to replant things. So now that I have my seeds in the holes, I have two seeds per hole. I am going to take my dirt again and I am going to cover them very lightly. I am not packing this down so much. I might pad it a little bit, but I'm not packing it to where my seeds will not have the energy to pop out the top. So that's where seed starting dirt really comes in the hand. It really comes handy because it does not restrict the seed from coming up to the top. It's a very, very loose dirt, guys. And I prefer that when I'm starting. So I have it down. It's not really packed down. It's just lightly pressed. And what I'm going to do is take my sprinkle hose. Do not use a drip hose, guys, the one that just has one single spout, because what you'll do is create little indention in there and you might lose your seed. So you use like a sprinkle type of hose that's just has a bunch of little sprinkles. Even if you have to use a water bottle and poke holes in the top, just sprinkle it lightly on top. And guys, I love my aquarium method, or whatever you want to call it. It's a greenhouse method, rather. I'll be formal with the term. I have plastic lining. You can buy these at any hardware store, planning shop, horse tack shop. Not tack, but, you know, like a tractor supply kind of deal, or Southern States. These are little plastic trays, okay? I put my plastic trays in a, like a shoebox kind of sort of deal, right? And I put my planter in here. I cover it up with the globe. And I put a heating light. I put it either in the heat, in a heated, like, lighted area, like my window. Or if for the first week, I might put a heating pad, which I have right here. I might put it under it so that, you know, the more heat that you can make in this type of environment, the better, because it will germinate quicker with a little bit of heat and moisture, because you're creating like the greenhouse effect, the humidity and everything within this globe space. All right, guys, so that's pretty much, that's easy, that's basic. That's what I do to plant my babies, guys. So I hope that your gardens this year are successful. I hope they flourish, baby, and they feed your family. So y'all stay tuned. I'll probably be back to y'all maybe in about 2 weeks for an update. That's typically when most of the seeds will start to sprout, 7 to 10 days. So when they start to sprout, I'll be back for an update, guys. Y'all be easy.